Good morning. Dobrý deň. Salamat. My name is Rafal Rohozinski, and I'm the CEO of the SecDev Group. I'd like to take a few minutes this morning to talk to you about the future. Now, it may seem strange that at a tech conference of all places, this would be necessary. But in reality, most of us are so focused on the products we are currently building and the services that we are operating on a day-to-day basis that looking into our crystal ball to see what's coming next is difficult, if not impossible. But in fact, there's lots that's coming our way, and it requires a leap of imagination to think about, but it's precisely there that the real opportunities hide. As my friend Roland Cloutier from TikTok said during his keynote earlier today, we are living through one of the most fundamental transformations in human history. By 2025, up to 25% of global gross domestic product, or GDP, will come from the digital economy. Digital technology is now being used by more than two-thirds of humanity, and in the next few years, connectivity will be as ubiquitous as sunlight as the next billion users make their way online using cheap, accessible mobile devices and interact with a digital world through a new universe of Internet of Things-enabled services. This new world has great promise and represents perhaps the single biggest leap forward in the empowerment of humanity thus far. But it's also a revolution that is being propelled by the creation of a new value, and that new value is data. Each one of the new devices and services that will be invented over the next 5 years will create, produce, and consume vast amounts of data. In point of fact, today we create more data on a daily basis than has been created throughout the entire history of humanity since the dawn of time. And arguably, this data, which some have called the new black gold, is going to be the single largest driver of change in our industry for the coming decades. So first, let me tell you why I think that data represents the opportunity space in the future, and then let me tell you how you can take advantage of it as a market opportunity. So first, the why. Data is invaluable for one simple reason. It makes prediction possible, and prediction is at the heart of any innovation in our industry. Prediction makes it possible for devices to act in the way we want them to, even before we ask. Prediction is key to behavioral advertising that creates a direct path between products and their consumers. Prediction is also important because it's necessary fuel for applications that are meant to make our lives easier, whether accessing government services, planning a vacation, or getting medical advice. But that's not all. Data is also valuable because it is the resource required to create predictive machines, those using artificial intelligence. And if data is the blood of the digital economy, then artificial intelligence is its beating heart. Without clean, precise, accurate data, the engine of artificial intelligence is not possible. But that also makes data valuable in other ways. Data describes not just objects and processes, but also our daily lives down to the level of our genetic code. The more detailed and the more personal the data, the more valuable that data becomes, and the greater the ethical questions as to who this data belongs to and how it can be used. Now, without getting into the ethical dimensions of privacy, what's important to understand is that protecting privacy and building barriers to accessing data is as much a business proposition as is the industry of mining and harvesting data. So how does this translate into real market opportunities? It really comes down to three things. First of all, it's seeing anything that you build as a data product. Creating, processing, and refining accurate information is a core business proposition of any future IT product or service. If your product or service does not create data that you can monetize, then its value is limited to the limited revenue that you can get from the individual consumer that buys or subscribes to your service. It may be hard to get your mind around the fact that the game, application, or device that you have spent the last 3 years thinking through and building is not the most important market opportunity, but the reality is that it's not. In fact, it's the aggregate data from your application that is the truly valuable commodity that has a larger market value in the global digital economy. Second, it's seeing privacy as an industry. Protecting data from being captured or creating the means for monetizing personal data is an important opportunity whose potential is only now being recognized. This may sound counterintuitive, especially what I've told you about the data industry, but the reality is that the more rare a commodity is, the greater the asking price that the owner of that commodity can charge for its use. Developing systems that give end users, that's you and me as individuals, the ability to monetize our own private data is not just the stimulus to creating a whole new range of services and applications, it's also the basis for a new personal data economy that will grow and scale as digital technologies permeate all aspects of our lives and the next billion internet users come online. Finally, the third major market opportunity is in artificial intelligence, but not in the way that I described it earlier in my talk. The present generation of algorithms being used across most advanced IE systems were invented a decade ago. And at the end of the day, the ability to innovate at that level is really only available to corporations and governments that are willing to make significant investments into the necessary infrastructure and research and education that can compete in this space globally. The market I'm referring to is the market for adversarial and counter-adversarial artificial intelligence. Now, if these words leave you scratching your head, remember back to what the IT industry was like in the 1990s, when computers and computer systems were being adopted rapidly by governments, corporations, and individuals, and no one really paid much attention to their security. That's the world that we live in currently with respect to artificial intelligence. We've started to deploy these systems widely across government, defense, and corporations with very little regard to the fact that they are vulnerable and can be attacked and misused just like any other information technology. In point of fact, artificial intelligence systems are uniquely vulnerable because of their dependence on clean and precise data to learn behavior. Messing with that data deliberately or feeding data which teaches artificial intelligence systems to work improperly is the equivalent of malware in the current cybersecurity industry. And yet, while we've seen a blossoming trillion-dollar opportunity in cybersecurity, the field of artificial intelligence security is still in its infancy. The consequences of adversarial AI are huge, especially given the dependence on these systems and the scale at which they are now being deployed across the global economy. But so is the opportunity then. At SecDev, we're investing heavily into the data future. We're focused principally on three lines of business. The first is risk intelligence as a service. We use a combination of commercial and open source methods to collect and analyze data from cyber, geospatial, geopolitical sources and bring our customers up to the moment 24/7 clean data feeds that identify specific risks and opportunities and are capable of feeding next generation artificial intelligence systems. The second is data science on demand, where we excel in building lightweight digital visualizations and AI platforms. And the third is AI defense. We are investing into bringing into life strategies for next generation cybersecurity aimed at the defense and protection of artificial intelligence systems from deliberate data poisoning and attack. To accomplish these aims, we have partnered with some of the world's leading scientific and educational institutions. We are also working with major technology companies to develop data intelligence feed that ensure the integrity of data used for artificial intelligence systems. And together with our partners, we are building systems and standards that aim to protect privacy by monetizing its value for its users. I'm honored to have had this opportunity to be here today. Our partnership with Kyrgyzstan stretches over 15 years. And in that time, we've launched and operated ambitious research programs that have helped our partners and government develop national ICT strategies, build cybersecurity capability, and develop strategic approaches to digital resilience. We have built and developed new approaches to privacy and data protection, and we have sponsored innovation through digital hackathons, such as the one held in Bishkek just prior to the pandemic. While today's opportunity to be with you virtually is an indication of just how far we've gotten in the digital revolution of the last two decades, I look forward to seeing all of you in person and wish you all the best for the remainder of KIT Forum 2021. Большое спасибо.